Hey everybody. One of my favorite things about car collecting is the memorabilia that goes with it. So knowing that this lineup on the 1994 Acura brochure consists of cars that I own, I set out to recreate the picture. And so presenting to you the modern day real world version of what Acura did in 1994. NSX, Legend sedan, the Vigor, and the Integra. Now, obviously my Integra is a few years newer than that because this color didn't come out until 4 years after the brochure, but you get the idea. Good afternoon, BAT community. Glad to be here with you. And I am Tyson. I'm wearing my t-shirt that says, "Give me five." That can only mean one thing. Today I'm gonna talk to you about my 1994 Acura Vigor GS 5-cylinder. This will be a supplemental video in addition to another one that I've already put together on this car. But this one is gonna focus specifically on the nitty-gritty things that I think you should know about if you're considering bidding on my car. I'm shooting this intentionally in broad daylight because it's perhaps the most unflattering light for any car, and it will allow me to point out the imperfections as I see them. This is a 26-year-old Acura. It was owned by only one prior owner. Her name was Kathy. She traded it into a Subaru dealership in 2015. That's when I bought it. So I guess this is as good a place as any to get started. We'll go kind of around the car exterior, then we'll go inside. We'll take a peek at the engine bay and the trunk, and we'll call it good. So here's your left rear molding. You can see there's a dimple right here, maybe from a small parking lot incident. Similarly, there's one up here on the driver door. The body is exceptionally clean on this car. I had the front and rear bumpers resprayed because they had been scuffed up. Other than that, I do believe the paint to be original. These are brand new tires as of within the last week, in fact. I tried to get Michelin 205 6015s for this car and was told that they aren't even made anymore, so I had to go with Yokohama. The wheels are 15 inches. They are refinished. I had them professionally reconditioned by a place here in Phoenix. Front of the car is in really nice shape. It does have bumper plugs because here in Arizona we don't use front plates. I don't have a bumper license plate bracket, so if you're taking this car to a state that needs a plate, I can't help you with that, unfortunately. There is a very cool, close-knit Acura Vigor Club community on Facebook, about 700 people in it, and I certainly recommend checking them out if you're into these cars. You really love to see this Arcadia green paint in the sun. It's really the best lighting to gain an appreciation for it. Super 90s color. Passenger side looks really good. Similarly, a couple small dimples in the side molding, but otherwise really nothing to talk about. This car was in Colorado for 15 years, from 2000 till 2015. So you'll see in the underbody pictures as part of the photo gallery, there is some small surface corrosion on the inner parts of the rear wheels, but nothing, as far as I can tell, that is worrisome. And the car has been largely kept dry for the last 5 years that I've had it. There is a little fitment issue here with the back bumper. Had been maybe lightly tapped, pushed in a bit. The muffler is an aftermarket Midas unit. It's never quite aligned, and you can kind of tell why. It's just a little bit off-center there in terms of the way that the tips are pointing, but it gets the job done. I'll include a copy of the recent Arizona emissions check last July. The car passed with flying colors. The breeze kind of decided to kick up on me right as I move into the interior. So hopefully it doesn't impact the sound quality. So this is an interior called Cognac, C-O-G-N-A-C. Almost like a saddle type of feel to it. All the leather is original with exception for one piece on the driver's seat that I'll show you that I had redone. Get that key out. This piece here on the edge was professionally replaced by a local shop here in Phoenix called Trim Fit that I've used for a variety of other projects. They do a really exceptional job. I have two sets of floor mats for this, factory mats, and I have been using mats on top of mats, so that really never sees much use at all. There are two noteworthy small chips in the windshield, one there and one up here. Neither one has spread, and a little bit of a scratch here. I don't know if you can kind of see it where the wiper's been hitting it. Which brings me to my next point. The wiper sprayer nozzles are not working right now. There's a hose that's disconnected and never been an issue for me. I don't drive the car in the rain, but FYI, I have the hose in the trunk and I'll show you. This has always been a little discolored. This is the passenger side airbag, which I believe was exclusive to the GS trim model for 1994. Of course, there is also a driver's side airbag. Cars equipped with anti-lock brakes, which were both very big deal features for safety back in the early 90s. I want to mention that the passenger side surround for the window glass here on the right rear is peeling up a bit with black. I've seen people either mask and spray this, or you can get like my buddy Joseph did and take a piece of vinyl, black vinyl, and fit it there. I just really never got around to worrying about it. Rear seat, not much else to talk about there. Let's go up front again. There's a little bit of tearing down here on the speaker fabric. Looks like a small rip right here on the center console. I am including a huge binder of records and the owner's manual, but this is a funky glove box because the way that it's dipped like this, when you put the owner's manual in there, it sort of folds it like this, and I didn't want the manual to be constantly forced to fit that way, so I just left, like, it ends up looking like this. This is my registration paperwork that's bent. Really weird glove box design. There's a kind of handy little compartment here for some business cards or whatever you want to put there. Here's the heart of the beast. It's the 2.5 liter, 176 horsepower inline 5. Very unique engine. Even today, it was kind of a revolutionary effort on Honda's part to put that together. There's a little bit of fading here on the grill surround. And it looks like a little bit of delamination here, if you can barely see it on the chrome piece down there. Hood insulation is really nice. The motorized antenna works when you power up the radio. I'm including with the car an accessory OEM spoiler with the LED brake light. However, I never did install it for a few reasons. You'd have to drill into the trunk, and you're supposed to also get heavier duty trunk springs to go with it, as well as whatever necessary wiring. So I just never really worried about it. Here's the trunk of the car. You can check out the photo gallery for the stuff I'm including with it, but there's a brochure, an 8-page Carfax report, laminated copy of the window sticker. This car was 28.7, including destination and handling. There's that hose I was telling you about for the washer fluid, owner's manual. All the keys for it are here. This is one that I got from AutoNation when I bought the car in Denver. It even includes the smaller valet key right here. There's the records book. A lot of good reading material. I'm not gonna give you this shirt, but I wanted to show it to you. Alive with five. How cool is that, right? I guess for the right price, you could talk me out of it, but it's well worn. My phone's acting like it's gonna overheat here. Welcome to Phoenix. Let's go ahead and start it up though. Everything works in here. I'll go ahead and power up the radio.
It's crushed up Cheerios.
And a little bit of aha take on me. I'm gonna give you a disc with this car, the top hits from 1994, so that if you decide to drive the car home, you'll have a period correct soundtrack. Kind of an interesting little feature here. The Legend has a similar little clock door. AC in this thing is ice cold. Compressor just kicked in. I love the old school analog knobs and dials. No electronic gimmickry in this car. There's a little miniature sunshade, sun visor, right in the middle of the other two big ones. If I'm not mistaken, these are speakers too, that were by the dome light. One of the coolest Vigor features for sure is the frameless front door. Actually all the doors, but check this out. So you put the window down, you have full mobility of the door there without the nuisance of a frame around it. I don't have a proper mount system to show you a detailed driving video, but I'm gonna roll around as best I can here. This parking lot. Include a clip as well of the car at freeway speed. That's going to do it for now, my friends. I appreciate you watching to this point, if you made it this far, and for taking a look at my auction. I'm really kind of brokenhearted about letting this go. It was a difficult car to find in the first place. I've enjoyed it for five solid years and shown it at a couple of shows, but everything has its time, and I'm looking to expand the collection a little bit and own other cars.